H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
Welcome to the videos of H2K Infosys. So in this particular video, we will see how to install the Java runtime environment. The Java runtime environment is a prerequisite for us to install Eclipse in our system. And before we install Eclipse in our system, it is important for us to understand that we need to have the Java runtime environment into our system rather. So going along with it, we're going to see certain things on the aspect of installation of Java runtime environment. First of all, we need to check up that do we have Java installed in our system or not. That is the first thing that we need to check up. So for checking that up, what we need to do is open up command prompt. So what we are going to do is type in the command called cmd in the search box out here. And in this particular search box, I'm going to type on or fire the command called java space hyphen version and click on the enter button. So if I get this kind of message, which shows me that what is the Java version, what is the runtime environment build that I have, and what is the hotspot build that we have, we will be sure that Java is installed in our system. And the version of Java, as far as my system is concerned, is showing me 1.8.0_91. Okay, and this the SE runtime environment build is 1.8.0_91.b15. And then hotspot 64-bit server is present, virtual machine is present in my system. So if we get this kind of messages, that precisely means that Java is installed in our system. The other way to basically check is that, other ways means that apart from command prompt. Okay, the other way is basically to check is that what we need to do is go to our my computer, and we need to open up the drive where the operating system is installed. Now in my system, the operating system is installed in C drive. So we are going to open up C drive and open up program files out here. In this program files folder, if we see a particular subfolder called as Java, we will be sure that Java is installed in our system. And if we expand the Java folder, we'll be able to see that the JRE 1.8.0_91 is also installed. This is the latest version of JRE, I believe so. So these are the two ways in which you can be sure that Java is installed in our system. Now let's say we do not have this Java folder, or let's say we do not get the message when we fire the command called Java space hyphen version in the command prompt. That precisely means that Java is not installed. So in that particular scenario, how do I get the Java installed in our system? So for that, what we need to do is that for installing Java for the first time in our machine, first we need to check the system type, and then we download Java, that is JRE, based on the platform and system type. Okay, and then install JRE and confirm your JRE is installed in the system. So going to the first aspect of looking at how to install Java for the first time into our systems, what we need to do is first check up the system type. For checking up the system type, we need to go to my computer, highlight it, right click and go to properties. This is going to give me the system type. Now if you see the system type out here, I have a 64-bit operating system and my platform is Windows 10. So with that information, I should be able to download Java. Now how do you download JRE? So for that, what we need to do is open up Google search engine and type in the keyword called download Java and click on the enter button. The first link basically gives us the path from where I can install the Java runtime environment. So click on this particular link. You're going to get this particular button called free Java download. So you got to click on this particular button. So click on this particular button. After clicking, what we need to do is that we need to check up what are the options in this page which has opened on clicking the free Java download button. So it opens up a page which shows you a button called agree and start free download. Do not click on this. What we need to do is first understand that what are the different flavors of Java that are present for different platforms. So for that, we need to click on this particular link. The link is called as See All Java Downloads. So click on that. We'll be able to see that what are the Java flavors available for each platform. So for Windows platform, these are the links from which we can download the JRE. For our Mac OS X platform, we can download the Java flavor from this particular link. For Linux platform, we have these links from which we can download the Java for the Linux platform. And for Sun Solaris, we have these particular versions or flavors of Java. So since I have Windows 64-bit operating system, I need to basically click on this particular link which says Windows Offline 64-bit. If I have a 32-bit operating system of Windows, then I have to click out here. So I'm going to click on this particular link to download the 64-bit version of Java, and it takes a bit amount of time to actually get it downloaded. Now, if you can see out here, the latest version is 8.update.91, which is already installed in my system. So I don't need to actually install it again, but for the sake of making you understand, let me open it and start installation of this particular version again. So I might get this particular window which will ask me to allow this application to make changes to a PC. Say yes to that. And after that, what we need to do is that we got to wait for the Java pop-up window to open. Sorry guys, I have a bad cold, so that's why I have this particular cuff. That's not going to affect the training anyways. So let us wait for the Java windows to open. Pop-up window to open, and let's see it has opened or not. It is still not open. I think it is still on the verge of opening that particular window. So let us wait for that. This kind of installation requires a lot of patience, so let's wait, and then we'll going to move forward. Yeah, the Java window is open. You get a welcome screen out here. So what we need to do is that we need to first understand that we do not have to change the destination folder. Let it be the default destination folder in which it is going to, you know, install the Java JRE software. So do not try to change the destination folder. Let it be the default destination folder wherever it is going to install the JRE. Because I have seen that if I try to change the destination folder, sometimes Java programs do not work correctly, or there is a conflict in the environment, or there is a problem in using Java programs. So let us not change the destination folder. Click on install button and it starts installing the Java JRE into our systems. So let's wait for that. And again, these kind of softwares require a bit of patience. So let's have a patience before we move forward. It doesn't take much time for us to actually, you know, download Java and install it. So I hope it will be over by some time, and we can then go ahead and check the rest part of it. So this particular pop-up window of JRE says that you have successfully installed Java. So I can close this particular window. Now, how do I basically get a green signal that Java has been installed in my system? So what I can do is that I can type in the command called cmd in the search box of the Windows and click enter button. This opens up the command prompt, and I'm going to basically now fire the command called Java space hyphen version and click on the enter button. So if I get this kind of messages which shows you the Java version and the SE runtime environment build versions and the virtual in machine versions of it. That means Java has got installed in my system. This is the first way of getting a sanguinity. The second way is that you can actually open up the drive in which you have installed your OS. My drive is C, so I'll open that. I'll see this Java folder inside the program files folder. So expand the Java subfolder and you'll see that this JRE 1.80_91 has been installed. If you expand this, you will see the bin folder, the library folder, the copyright license, readme text, release, third party license, readme text, third party license, readme Java FX text, and welcome.html. These are the, you know, files and folders present inside the JRE. Now the library folder contains nothing but libraries which are needed for us to, you know, create our Java codes, or which are needed to ease out our coding structure. The bin folder contains different configurations files to configure the JRE into our system. And the other files are your text files, which are used to look at the licenses factors of the JRE and how to use it. And there's a welcome page in the form of welcome.html. So if you see these kind of, you know, files and folders inside the JRE folder, we are sure that JRE, or rather Java, is installed in our system. So this is one way of installation of Java. This is the clear way of installation of Java rather. The next thing which is present in our slide is to upgrade JRE to the latest version. Now, for example, I need to know, or I do not know rather, what is the Java that is installed in my system. How do I find out what is the version of Java that is installed in my system? So it's the same thing out here. What we need to do is just open up the command prompt by firing the command called cmd inside the search box. And if we just type in again the same command called Java space hyphen version, we'll be able to know, you know, the version of the Java installed in my system. Right now, the latest version is 1.8.0_91. So latest version is installed. Now, let's say you have an earlier version, let's say 1.8.73 or 1.8.81. Now, you want to upgrade to the new version, that is the latest version, 1.8.0_91. Then what we need to do is that we got to open up the same, you know, Google search engine, okay, and click on this particular link again, click on this free Java download, okay, and we'll be able to see what is the latest version. This is the latest version. For example, hypothetically, I understand that I have an older version. I want to upgrade to the latest version. So what do I need to do is that I need to go and check up my system type. The system type I can go and check up by just clicking, right clicking on the my computer, go to properties and check up the system type. I have 64-bit. So what I am doing out here is that I will go to see all Java downloads and check up this Windows offline 64-bit. Now from here I can download the latest version. Just click on that and start installation of it by the pop-up windows which are opening, or which will open on installing the JRE which has got downloaded by clicking on this particular link. So that's how you upgrade your version. Do not do any other, or do not carry out any other ways to upgrade your Java version. You can upgrade your Java version by the same procedure that I have shown you right now. Now let's say you want to basically, you know, try to remove the older versions. If you want to remove older versions, what you need to do is just type in the same keyword called download Java. It is going to open up this particular link, the first link, which belongs to java.com/download. Click on this link, you will see that the same page opens. Click on this free Java download. And there is a, you know, a link called remove older version. That means it is removing the older versions of your JRE. If you want to remove, you click on this particular remove older version link. It will ask you to, you know, click on an applet kind of stuff, or kind of a add-on or a pop-up stuff. Click yes on that pop-up stuff, and then it will automatically, you know, remove the older versions of JRE. Do not try to remove it manually. Always use this particular link to remove your older versions of your JRE if you want to do it. So that's about it in terms of installation of JRE, which is actually a prerequisite for installation of Eclipse IDE. Now we will be using Eclipse IDE for the purpose of Java, for creating our Java codes, or for compiling our Java codes and for running our Java codes. There are other IDEs also available, like your NetBeans. NetBeans is also a free IDE like Eclipse IDE. NetBeans belongs to Oracle, but the features given in NetBeans personally for me does not match with the features that are present in Eclipse IDE. Obviously, the Eclipse IDE features are far better than NetBeans IDE, according to me. Okay, so that's about it in this particular video. Thanks for watching it, and we'll see you again in the next video. Thank you very much.